This is one of the ultimate forgotten barbecue foods. Is it still a must-try recipe, or is there a good reason why we forgot about it?
Big thanks to Kamada Joe for sponsoring this episode.
Most of the time when people start talking to me about forgotten barbecue foods, I kind of get this feeling like there's a good reason why we forgot about that food. But this one, it might be different. I had this before, and I think this might be one of those perfect barbecue foods. And of course, I'm not talking about chicken, beef, pork. I'm talking about rabbit. Nowadays, rabbit is super, super cheap. You can order it online and get it almost anywhere. But just think about how easy it is to breed rabbits. And that's one of those things why it used to be super, super popular back in the days. This will be a staple on barbecue restaurants all over the US, and now it isn't. I think I have the perfect, super easy recipe to make this juicy, tender, and super, super tasty. Let's get started. Rabbit itself is lean, and that means it's just like chicken. You gotta help it a little bit to become extra, extra tasty. And therefore, I'm gonna make a brine. Now I have 1.5 liters of water here, and I'm going to add the Pitmaster X classic barbecue seasoning to that to make a brine. And that's the cool thing about Pitmaster X seasoning. You can add this to create a brine. And I even written down the ratios on the side of the package so you can do this too at home super, super easily. Now, of course, if you want to, you can find the recipe on our website as well. Of course, if you don't have Pitmaster X seasoning, you can find the recipe for it on our website. I'm gonna stir this up. And one of the main ingredients of the seasoning is salt. And that salt is going to help brine this rabbit. They're already decapitated, which means there's no head, there's no leg still attached, just like with the chicken. I'm gonna pour the brine over the rabbit. I'm going to cover it up with a little bit of foil. And now I'm gonna stick this in the fridge for at least 4 hours. And this chicken. I'm not into the whole rabbit yet. I'm gonna stick this rabbit into the fridge for 4 hours, and then it's gonna be a better rabbit. It's gonna be more juicy. They're done brining, and they picked up a bit of color from the seasoning, and they soaked up a lot of juices. I'm gonna put them on a tray, and I'm gonna season them on the outside with the Pitmaster X seasoning. Of course, I'm gonna season all sides, the inside as well. Now I realized that maybe this is a forgotten piece of barbecue because people have gotten so sensitive about food. Last one, and of course I'm gonna give them the opportunity to dry up a little bit on the rack. Plenty of flavor on it. There we go, this is looking good. Now, I'm gonna give it about 10 minutes or so. In the meantime, I'm gonna fire up my barbecue. First, I'm gonna put in some big block charcoal, a couple of fire starters, and then a chunk of smoke wood, making sure that I don't let it catch fire yet. Once the fire starters are burned down, I'm gonna put in the heat deflectors, grill grate, and it's time to put on the forgotten barbecue food. Now this is not a thick piece of meat, really, really thin, especially on the breast. So I'm gonna put this in, I'm gonna keep my eye on the temperatures, and we're going to smoke this at a temperature of 120 degrees Celsius. And to do that, I'm gonna close the lid, vent to almost all the way closed, and this is about half a finger thick, and then the top vent to 1.5 stripe open. That should get the temperature inside the Kamada Joe Big Joe up to 120 degrees Celsius, which is around 240 degrees Fahrenheit. The rabbits have been cooking for about an hour now, and I think we're getting close to the end result. I wanna make it real barbecue, so, ooh, nice. We're up to 88 degrees here. How are we doing in the butt? Almost, well, 77 degrees Celsius core temperature. 79, 78, so we're getting to the temperature where I wanna go. I wanna go to 92 degrees Celsius core temperature because that is the moment that I can just shred this thing apart. You're like, you have one of those chicken legs that just falls apart and it's really oozy. I want that, but then with my rabbit. Now the rabbit does look good at the moment. It's really, it's got that smoke color, it's got a little dry bark building up on the outside, but I want more. I'm gonna brush on a raspberry chipotle barbecue sauce by Blues Hog, but you can use any type of barbecue sauce that you prefer, as long as it's a little bit sweet. We gotta make it barbecue. It's gotta be a little bit of sour, a little bit of sweetness. That's gonna work really well with the classic barbecue rub and the brine. You don't wanna do this too early in the cook because the sugars might burn. But at this point, we're good to go. We're just gonna put on a little layer and make that nice and sticky, make them shine. Now that is starting to look good. I'm gonna close the lid. I'm going to let it continue to cook. I'm thinking just about 10, 15 more minutes, these should be done. I got my rabbits at 92 degrees Celsius core temperature. So let's take them off, see what happens. Woo-hoo-wee. Now that is rabbit. Boy, yo. Of course, I gotta let these rest, but I checked for temperature, but I also felt with the thermometer that the meat just relaxed at 92 degrees Celsius. It's like with brisket. You gotta probe it, and once it starts to relax, you know you hit the sweet spot. Now all I gotta do is just wait for these to be done, but oh man, they look so good. I don't see a reason why people stopped eating these. I don't know where to begin, but I feel I'd best begin with the leg. Just let me see if we can just do a small incision, pop it. Look at that. That is good. Break the connection. Is it juicy? Let's find out. Shave off. That is juicy. So in the juicy part, we definitely have success. Let me grab that. It's a little hot still, but how does the autonomy of the rabbit actually work? It just annihilated the leg of the, of the rabbit. Super, super easy. Just finding that bone, but now it's just not where I'm expecting it to be. Never mind. That's tasty. I know what people like to say. Rabbit tastes like chicken. Rabbit does not taste like chicken.
Oh, this is good.
I don't see any reason why we're not eating this more often. Why are we not enjoying rabbit? All you gotta do is take it up to 92 degrees Celsius. It's not the required for food safety temperature. It's the temperature where everything becomes juicy and soft. Look at that. Juicy piece of meat. That is all good. It is juicy, but I wouldn't say it is as tender as chicken, but it's super, super tasty. If you have a rabbit running around and you think, what am I gonna do with that rabbit? Now you know.
I'm sorry.
I had to make the joke.
It's whole purpose of the rabbit.
I mean, come on. Why not?
It looks so cool. It's like picture perfect.
Looks good, right?
It looks really good. Definitely different than chicken.
It's not strong in flavor.
I expected a lot more bark, which is just saying beforehand, because it's 92 degrees.
Hey, you want a piece? Come on. Lekker, huh? You want more?